thinking the other day about being picked on at school and trying to fit in. And there's loads of different reasons somebody would just make fun of you for no reason. One of the first things that came to mind was wearing glasses. Probably once a day that didn't go by where I didn't get called Joe 90, Specky, or XR4i. When you think of the amount of kids that should really wear glasses, if everybody actually did put them on, nobody would look that nerdy because there'd just be pretty much everybody wearing them, but yeah, wearing glasses. One of the worst things about going to primary school, if you didn't have much money, was trainers or tennis shoes. There's only certain brands that you could wear, like Adidas or Nike. If you wore anything else, you got teased. Some of the worst brands you could wear were things like Hi-tec or Dunlop, and Tesco tearaways were probably the worst. If you ever went to school in anything that wasn't fashionable, you just had the taken all day. Speaking of which, one time it was snowing, and to stop me slipping over, my mum sent me school in snow boots, and everybody was mercilessly just ripping the out of me all day, saying, "Oh, you wearing girls' shoes, and who do you think you are?" And so I never wore them ever again. But shoes, you miss them when you don't have them. One thing that was different than when I was at school compared to nowadays, it's fashionable into all your like Marvel movies. But one memory I've got is taking me Star Wars annual to school. And it was for Return of the Jedi, to be more specific. Routinely got knocked out of my hands by other kids who thought it was hilarious. And at this point in my life, I hadn't seen the Karate Kid film. And the only technique that I come up with was doing this. Spinning round like this, hopefully knocking people out as they came to me. But only figured out through it going wrong multiple times that people could just bend down. And as I was rotating, they just punched me in the nuts.
God damn it!
And so yeah, it's all come and stuck, but never mind. If you want, leave in the comments anything that you got picked on for at school. For no reason whatsoever. Talking about being picked on for no reason, let's go over to the comment leaver section. A lot of people were saying, "Oh, I wanted to end last week's video." If you look carefully, it's in the background with a note of order sign on it. I had to get it back up and running. I had to do a complete teardown. I've replaced the belts. I've switched it on and off again. I've put a new comment relief nose on, and we should be ready to go. Let's give it the first pull of the new comment lever. Smooth, it was like being a Burt Reynolds tramlam. See what the first comment says. This is from DDDUX. "You have a big pimple right in the center of your forehead. It might be malignant."
It's not a tumor.
Well, I've had that ever since I can remember, really. And I hope not anyway, but you know, touch wood, you never know. Whatever that means. Let's do the second pull of the new comment lever. It's all refreshing, it's like a whole new thing. Oh, she's from Culture Dog. Shout out to Culture Dog. Oh, Thunder Buddies. Oh, we both bassists. I think that's where he's going at. Nice list of bassists. Wasn't the usual 10 or so guys everybody chooses. Nice to see some love for Newstead too. He had huge shoes to fill and absolutely crushed it.
Keep on slapping the bass, man.
Slapping that bass, man. I slapping the bass.
Please don't do that.
Tried to pick some bass players they genuinely liked, but glad they weren't just the same as everybody else's. And here's the last comments. Third time lucky. Even though the other comments were good. This is from Stefan Braun. "Just go f*** yourself, the lock." Well, what a way to end. And on that bombshell, keep it locked.
Thanks for watching The Legends of Cherry Hill. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and consider subscribing.